So good morning, my intelligent students. I hope my all students are fit and fine. Yesterday we were reading autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. We were reading a very beautiful chapter, My Childhood. And this chapter I have told you yesterday, it has been taken from a very famous book. Okay. And this book is written by APJ Abdul Kalam. Okay. And the name of the book is Wings of Fire, and this book shows us the biography, autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam, and this chapter is an extract from this book. And yesterday we were able to read only, I think, 4 paragraphs. Okay. So we were able to read only 4 paragraphs. So I'm going to start from 5th one. So in this chapter, what we have read yesterday, we have come to know that Abdul Kalam, he belonged to a very middle class family, Muslim family. Okay. And he was living there in the island town of Rameswaram, Tamil Nadu. He had a great impact of his parents, his teacher and his friends. Okay. His father was not so much well educated. He was not so much rich, but he was very much kind and sensible, intelligent person. Okay. And he provided a very secure childhood to Abdul and his brother and sister. The name of Abdul's mother is Ashiyama. Okay. So Abdul has that great personality, Abdul Kalam, APJ Abdul Kalam. He has learned honesty and self-discipline from his father, okay, and deep kindness from his mother. It means all about the valuable things he has learned from his parents, okay. So when did he earn his first wages? He told about this thing that when he was working as a helper to his cousin, that he was doing a work of, you can say, distribution of newspaper. So at that time, Second World War was going on. Second World War was going on. Aparan is asking me, what is the meaning of helpmate? So, bachche, meaning of helpmate is wife. I have told you yesterday also. The meaning of helpmate is wife. Okay. So when he earned his first wages, he was only 8 years old at that time. At that time, there was a great demand of tamarind seeds. So he used to collect all those seeds and he used to sell them in market. In this way, he started earning money. In his childhood, Abdul Kalam, APJ Abdul Kalam, that great scientist, he had 3 friends, but see, APJ Abdul Kalam, he was basically a Muslim, but his 3 friends were Hindu Brahmins. Okay. Once, now, what happened? But about the career, that what they became, all this is given in paragraph number 4th. We have gone through paragraph number 4th yesterday. Now, let's move to paragraph number 5. So Simran, you show me your face, then I'll give you chance to read 5th paragraph. Simran. Okay. Okay, Simran, you just read 5th paragraph.
Yes, ma'am. During the annual Sri Sita Ram Kalyanam ceremony, our family used to arrange boats with a special platform for carrying idols of the Lord from the temple to the marriage site situated in the middle of the pond called Ramatirtha, which was near our house. Events from the Ramayana and from our life of the prophet were the bedtime stories my mother and grandmother would tell the children in our family.
Read next also, I will be explaining both.
One day, when I was in the fifth standard at the Rameshwaram Elementary School, a new teacher came to our class. I used to wear a cap, which marked me as a Muslim. And I always sat in the front row next to Ramanadha Shastri, who wore the sacred thread. The new teacher could not stomach at a Hindu priest's son sitting with a Muslim boy. In accordance with our social ranking, as the new teacher saw it, I was asked to go and sit on the back bench. I felt very sad, and so did Ramanadha Shastri. He looked utterly downcast as I shifted to my seat in the last row. The image of him weeping when I shifted to the last row left a lasting impression on me.
See, very beautiful and very touching paragraph is given from the autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. Now you all should be eager to know about his childhood days, that when he was a child, how was he, which kind of life he was having in school. Okay. So in the fifth paragraph, APJ Abdul Kalam, that great personality, missile man, he is writing about his childhood. He is writing that annual Sri Sitaram Kalyanam ceremony was going on. And what was the work of their family? Their family used to arrange boards. Okay. And when their family used to arrange boards, and what was the work of that board, that they used to carry idols of. Idols, you can say. You know about the meaning of idols? Tell me. Can anybody tell me the meaning of idols? Yes, very good. I want to see the level of ninth class. Yes, statues. Yes. So they used to carry idols of Lord Rama from the temple and from temple to the marriage site. And what, where was that situated? In the middle of the pond called Rama Tirtha. Okay, and that pond was very much near to house. So what kind of environment was there in their family? That during bedtime, okay, the stories from Ramayana, from the life of prophet, such kind of stories were told by mother and grandmother in the family. Okay, so such kind of environment it was given to him. Clear? So after that it is given. So now he is telling about his experience that when he was in fifth class, how was his school life? You all should be eager to know how was his school life. That when he was only in fifth class, you can say near about 10 years old. So he was studying in Rameshwaram Elementary School. So new teacher came in his school. Okay. And at that time, APJ Abdul Kalam, he used to wear a cap. So that cap, which is of white color, so that was marked him that he was a Muslim boy. Okay. And he always used to sit in the front row. Okay. And this front row was just next to one of his classmates. What was his name? Ramanadha Shastri. Okay. So that boy, he was wearing a sacred thread. In Hindi, we say it just like janeu. Okay, priest families, they wear it. I think you might have seen it. Yes or not? Yes or not? Yes. So when teacher came to know that one Muslim boy is sitting along with a Hindu's priest son, so that teacher could not tolerate this thing. Because according to the mentality of that teacher, according to the social ranking, the teacher has seen APJ Abdul Kalam, he was asked to go and sit on the back bench. At that time, APJ Abdul Kalam felt so sad because he was not allowed to sit with that Hindu boy. Okay. So when APJ was told to change his seat by teacher, so he was feeling so bad, and Ramanadha Shastri, he was also looking so bad, and he felt really so sad. So he was feeling downcast. Okay, he was feeling so downcast, and he he had to APJ Abdul Kalam, he had to shift his seat in the last row. So that boy, when he started crying, that image of his friend who was crying only because of this discrimination, and this discrimination was done by a teacher, when the you can say arrangement of the seats were done on the basis of you can say caste, that he belonged to Hindu family and second one belonged to Muslim family, and because of that shifting in seats were done by a teacher, so that boy started crying. So this was not tolerated at all by both the boys. It was really a sad situation. So could not stomach means could not tolerate. So teacher could not tolerate that boy, one Hindu and one Muslim, they both are sitting together. It was not being tolerated by a teacher in that kind of environment when Second World War near about 1939, that time was going on. Clear? Clear? I'm going to read chat box if you have any message. Okay. Simran is having a query about from the chapter mail. Okay, Simran, yes, you can unmute yourself and ask. Yes, Simran, where are you? Unmute yourself and speak whatever you want to ask. Simran is lost somewhere, I'm not able to find. Let me find. Yes, Simran. Bachche, unmute yourself, yes. And ask me, what do you want to say? Yes, Simran. Yes, Simran, what do you want to ask, bachche? I have given you a chance. You told me to unmute yourself. You want to say something? Yes, Simran. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, my query is not from the chapter. Ma'am, I want to ask if the like the video we needed to make for the head boy and head girl, are those still like we can make and send?
Yeah, you send me message regarding that. I will be asking activity head, then I will let you know within 1 day. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Let me ask her. If she allows me, then I'll be giving you permission.
And ma'am, if she gives you permission, then can you please forward the instructions again?
Okay. I'll be doing it.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Now, this was about 6th paragraph. Okay, now let's move to next paragraph. Okay, Dhiren, you read next paragraph.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, before reading, I want to ask a question from you. Ma'am, as you said that Abdul Kalam was earning a wage from the by distributing newspapers. So was his family in the need of money, or he was just earning for its right?
See, they were having a large family, so many brothers, so many sisters, and they belonged to a middle class family. And during that time, Second World War was going on, the family might be in the problem of in need of money, and moreover it was a very large family. So he felt that because one of his cousin, he required help. So when he told one of his cousin, APJ Abdul Kalam, to help him in distributing the newspapers, APJ Abdul Kalam agreed. So this was one of the situation, and this situation gave him a chance to earn money. At that time he felt so much pride of himself, he felt so much proud of himself that at this age he started earning money because situation became like this.
Okay, ma'am. So it was a part-time job?
Yes, it was a part-time job that he was only distributing newspapers. He was collecting tamarind seeds and giving in the market. So whenever he was doing such kind of odd jobs and he was getting good amount of money for that, so he thought that he should continue with this. Moreover, he was getting good money and he thought that he was earning his wages in this right way. Moreover, the situation was like that. Everybody was in problem because during Second World War, the problem was different. they were in need of money because there was a complete, you can say, curfew like that. People were in need, okay? And, need arises like that. So it was a chance, it was such like that circumstance which gave him a good opportunity to earn money. So at this young age, when he got a chance to earn money, he accepted this thing and he continued this thing. Suppose you are now of which age? Now tell me.
I'm 14 years old.
Suppose any opportunity comes in front of you, any of your cousin approaches you and he says that Dhiren, there is a chance and you can earn money, you can do this odd job. Will you be able to do? And if you think that, yes, I'm in need of money, my family is in problem, they require money, so I should do this. So you will definitely go for it. And if you have a courage, if you have a passion to do, so you will. But if you think, no, I don't require, why should I go for extra odd jobs? I belong to a very rich family, why should I go this? And you don't have a spirit to do something extra. So would you do? No. Okay? So it happens according to circumstances and from his passion also. He was like a middle class boy and he wanted to do that. Clear? Your doubt is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now
yes, ma'am.
Paragraph.
Yes, ma'am. After school, we went home and told our respective parents about the incident. Lakshmana Shastri summoned the teacher and in our presence told the teacher that he should not spread the poison of social inequality and communal intolerance in the minds of innocent children. He bluntly asked the teacher to either apologize or quit the school and the island. Not only did the teacher regret his behavior, but the strong sense of conviction Lakshmana Shastri conveyed ultimately reformed this young teacher.
Okay. Now, bachi, in this paragraph, there is a word, communal intolerance. Write down its meaning. It means not tolerating another community. Not tolerating another community. Okay. So what happened in this paragraph, we have come to know that when such kind of bad incident occurred in their classroom, that discrimination was done by a teacher on the basis of caste, seats were shuffled on only on that basis. So after school, they went home, they told about this incident to their respective parents. It means APJ Abdul Kalam told about this incident to his parents and that Hindu boy told this incident to his parents. So Lakshmana Shastri summoned the teacher. Summoned means, what is the meaning of summoned? Summoned means called. Called that teacher in their presence and they told the teacher that there is no need to spread the poison of social inequality and such kind of environment that you are not going to tolerate another community. Such kind of poison should not be given in the mind of innocent children because they are studying only in fifth class and such kind of things are taught to them that they should discriminate on the basis of caste, that if someone is Hindu and someone is Muslim, they should not be friend with each other. So such kind of intolerance should not be spread among students. Okay, so he bluntly, what is the meaning of bluntly? Bachcha, write down. Are you all writing? Let me see. Are you all writing? So bluntly means very much clearly. Clearly, or you can say very much directly. So directly, clearly, he asked the teacher to say sorry or just leave the school and leave that island also where the school was situated. So after that incident, the teacher apologized. Not only the teacher rejected his behavior, but strong sense of conviction means strong sense of opinion, disbelief, it was conveyed to that teacher and the teacher was completely reformed. Reformed means completely changed. Changed. Changed in a positive sense. It means he regretted. He learned from that mistake that yes, I should not do this discrimination on the basis of caste among students. Such kind of things should not be taught to fifth class students. So he realized his mistake and he apologized for his mistake. Okay. Have you written the meaning of this difficult words? You write them side by side, only then you'll be able to understand. Okay, after that, Laksh Jairath, you read next paragraph. Eighth paragraph, Laksh.
Yes. Yes, ma'am. On the whole, the small society of Ramswaram was very rigid in the terms of segregation of different social groups. However, my science teacher, Siva Subramania Iyer, through an orthodox Brahmin with a very conservative wife, was something of a rebel. He did his best to break the social barriers so that people from varying backgrounds could mingle easily. He used to spend hours with me and would say, Kalam, I want you to develop so that you are on a par with highly educated people of the big city.
This is a very good message giving paragraph. On the whole, the small society of Rameswaram was very rigid. It means when any segregation means separation. Write down the meaning of segregation. Segregation means separation. Okay. Write down the meaning of mingle. Mingle means mix. On par. On par means you can say on par. It means equal. Equal and perturbed. Perturbed means you can say disturbed. So according to this paragraph, we have come to know that whenever any kind of separations were done in social groups in that area, so what was the result of that? That whole of the small society, not only his family, whole of the small society of Rameswaram, they were completely against it. Okay. So when his science teacher, Siva Subramaniam Iyer, okay, and he belonged to a very orthodox Brahmin and he was having a very conservative wife, okay, was something of a rebel. So they were also became in that category. So he even also tried his level best to break the social barrier. It means whatever the social barrier were made, that people were having different kind of backgrounds, they could mix together, they could mingle together. Okay, so that science teacher, he used to spend so many hours with APJ Abdul Kalam and would say that I want you to develop so that you are in a par with the highly educated people of the big cities. Okay, so what was the mentality of that science teacher? That science teacher told APJ Abdul Kalam that I want that you should be well educated. Okay, you should develop yourself in that way that you will be equal, you will be treated equal with other well-educated people. It means there will be no discrimination on the basis of caste, creed and religion. All will be in the same category. So this was the perspective of science teacher. So science teacher used to teach them in this way and he was in the favor of APJ Abdul Kalam that he wanted to see him developing in this way. He wanted that his student should be that well-educated and he should be in the category of other well-educated people. He should not be discriminated on the basis of caste, creed, etc. Okay, now let's move to ninth paragraph. Arzu, you read ninth paragraph. Where are you? Yes, Arzu.
One day he invited me to his home for a meal. His wife was horrified at this idea of a Muslim boy being invited to dine in a ritual pure kitchen. She refused to serve me in her kitchen. Sivas Burmania liar was not perturbed, nor did he get angry with his wife, but instead served me with his own hands and sat down beside me to eat his meal. His wife watched us from behind the kitchen door. I wondered whether she had observed any difference in the way I ate rice, drank water, or cleaned the floor after the meal. When I was leaving his house, Sivas Burmian liar invited me to join him for a dinner again the next weekend. Observing my hesitation, he told me not to get upset, saying, once you decide to change the system, such problems have to be confronted. When I visited his house the next week, Sivas Burmania liar's wife took me inside her kitchen and served me food with her own hands.
Now there is one another incident that is shared by APJ Abdul Kalam in this chapter from his childhood. That is also a very interesting incident. See, when he was in fifth class, he was near about 9 to 10 years old. Which kind of incident did he face in his life and how did he tackle them? Which kind of mentality people were having in his surrounding? Which kind of mentality even the teachers were having? Some teachers were in favor and some teacher was not in favor. So what kind of environment was in the neighborhood? What kind of students? What kind of friends he was having? So all we are going to come to know about this APJ Abdul Kalam, great missile man, who is a role model for everybody. Okay, so let's read about this. Very interesting incident is told about him. One day, what happened? He was invited for a meal, okay, by that person. So when his wife came to know that Muslim boy is going to come in our pure kitchen, so she refused to serve him food. See how, what kind of discrimination was there? That person in which family he was going to have a dinner with them. They were of a Hindu family and APJ was a Muslim boy. Okay. So it was ritually pure. Ritually prayer means outsiders would not come in that kitchen. Okay. So that lady, she refused to serve him food. So Siva Subramaniam Iyer, that was his teacher, he was not perturbed. He was not disturbed at that moment. He did not get angry with his wife. Instead, he served food to his student, okay, with his own hands. And he sat down beside him to eat his meal. His wife was looking at that boy and her husband from behind the kitchen. So she was surprised that did she notice any change, the way he was having rice, the way he was drinking water, the way he was cleaning floor after taking food. Okay. So when he was about to leave his house, what happened? Siva Subramaniam Iyer invited him to join him dinner again in the next weekend. Next week, he was again invited, saying that if you really want to change the system, so you have to face a problem like this as you are facing in my house, that my own wife is not ready to serve you food. So you have to face such kind of problems if you really want to change the whole system. So next week when APJ Abdul Kalam visited their house, so same wife, okay, she took him inside the kitchen and served him food with her own hands. It means within 1 week, the mentality of that lady got changed. Okay? Because she realized her folly. She realized her mistake that she was wrong. You can see in the picture. Earlier, she had a hatred for that boy. That how a Muslim boy could enter in my holy kitchen. But next week, when he was invited again, food was served. You can see in the picture. So this is very interesting chapter. We are coming to know about so many facts, so many truths about the life of APJ Abdul Kalam. So shall I move further? Okay, 10th paragraph. Arzu, you read 10th paragraph. Arzu, you read 10th paragraph.
Yes, ma'am. Then the Second World War was over and India's freedom was imminent. Indians will build their own India, declared Gandhiji. The whole country was filled with an unprecedented optimism. I asked my father for permission to leave Rameswaram and study at the district headquarters in Ramanthapuram.
So what happened? It was a time of Second World War. Wait. Now the Second World War was going on, but now it was a time that Second World War was completely over and India was going to get independence. It was about to take place. So now Indians will make their own India. And it was declared by Gandhiji at that time. So whole of the country was filled with that unprecedented. It means, meaning is given in front of you, unparalleled, new optimism. Optimism means positive thinking. Okay. So whole of the country was having positive thinking that this is going to take. New positive thinking was about to take place in India. So at that time, APJ Abdul Kalam, he asked his father to have permission to leave Rameswaram and study at the district headquarters in Ramanathapuram. So he took permission from his father that now he wanted to leave Rameswaram, that place, and he wanted to go for a higher study where Ramanathapuram. Okay, so this permission was taken from his father by APJ Abdul Kalam. Now rest of the chapter, 11th paragraph is left. I think we should read it. Okay. Now Arzu, continue with the 11th also. Arzu, continue with the 11th. He told me as if thinking aloud, Abdul, I know you have to go to grow. You have to go away to grow. Does the seagull not fly across the sun alone and without a nest? He quoted Khalil Gibran to my hesitant mother. Your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of life longing for itself. They come through you, but not from you. You may give them your love, but not your thoughts, for they have their own thoughts. So very beautiful paragraph is given in the end, because when this decision was taken by APJ Abdul Kalam that he wanted to go abroad for higher study, but when mother was not giving him permission, so what teaching, what message was given by father to his wife, that he has said so beautifully that these children, they are now growing, okay, and they have to go, okay, they are not, you can say, they are not supposed to stay at one place. And he has taken a very beautiful wording from Khalil Gibran. The meaning of that wording is that every person has a chance to go further. Every person has a chance to grow, to flourish in their life. Whatever they want to do, they should spread their wings and they should fly. It means whatever the vision, whatever the dreams they are having, they should soar high in the sky and they should try their level best to touch the zenith, to touch the top. So when mother was not ready to send their children, so what? How beautifully she was made understood that no problem, you have given birth to them. Okay, they are your son, they are your daughter. You just love them, but you can you it doesn't mean that you are going to stick your thoughts on them, because they have their own thoughts, they have their own vision, they have their own dreams, but and whatever they want to have in their life, they should go abroad, they should go far away, they should try to achieve those goals. And in this way, such kind of beautiful message was given by father, and father gave permission to APJ Abdul Kalam to do something in your life. Whatever you want to achieve, you should achieve, and you should go away, okay, wherever you want to go in order to achieve your goals. Okay, so these are the question answers that we will do tomorrow, and I hope my all students will be ready with their answers. Okay, and I can ask any of the child to tell me the answer. You have one day till tomorrow, you can prepare your answers, but write down only in rough hints only. We will be discussing tomorrow. Okay, bachche, now thank you and have a nice day.